I have been seeing videos all over YouTube about the IVF 2 week wait. These videos focus on two things. Number one, that you have to wait 2 weeks to have a pregnancy test after IVF. And two, that there are things you can do during those 2 weeks to improve the chance for embryo implantation. Both are wrong. Stay tuned to find out why. The final step during IVF is the placement of the embryo into the uterus. This is known as the embryo transfer. Once the embryo is in the uterine cavity, what happens? How long does it take to implant? And how long does it take for a pregnancy test to be positive? Back in 1999, scientists followed over 200 women for 6 months. They tested them every day to determine the day of ovulation and for the earliest signs of pregnancy. They found the earliest evidence for pregnancy implantation was 6 days after ovulation, and the latest was 12 days. 85% of implantations occurred 8 to 10 days after ovulation. By the way, this study was done by testing hormones in the urine. If you do blood testing, then you'll find the times are even shorter. We know that embryos do not implant until they have reached the blastocyst stage. We know from observing embryos in the laboratory that it takes 5 to 6 days to go from the time when sperm meets an egg to become a blastocyst. That means that when a blastocyst is transferred into the uterus, implantation could occur as early as the next day, and that the vast majority of embryos have implanted within 5 days. At the very latest, it's a week later. The cells of the embryo produce the hormone HCG. Once the embryo implants, the HCG is absorbed into the mother's blood and it can be measured. So why are you waiting for 2 weeks to do a pregnancy test? Okay, it does make a difference if you are doing a fresh embryo or a frozen embryo transfer. Why? A fresh transfer is done 5 days after an egg retrieval, which is 7 days after a woman has taken the trigger injections. The trigger injections usually contain HCG. If you do a pregnancy test too soon after injecting HCG, it might give you a false positive result. So with a fresh transfer, you can't say for sure if you have a pregnancy unless you repeat the HCG blood test and see it going up, meaning a pregnancy, instead of down, which means it's just left over from the injection. With frozen transfers, there is no HCG injection given, so any amount of HCG found in mom's blood means that an embryo has implanted. You don't have to wait and repeat the HCG level. What happens to an embryo after the transfer before it implants? Generally, the embryo is continuing to develop. It also has to go through the process of hatching, which means it is breaking out of the hard shell that surrounds it. Well, what do we think of people trying to sell you on some supplement or program during your 2 week wait to increase the chance for implantation? Frauds! Most of the embryos have already implanted or aren't going to. So save your money, stop watching those videos, and subscribe to Infertility TV now. Performing the pregnancy test is one of the types of tests done on patients with infertility. To learn about other fertility tests, check out this playlist. But before you go, be sure to like this video. If you have a suggestion for a future episode, leave it in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to Infertility TV now. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.